We want to solve the given linear equation in one variable. Normally, when solving an equation like this, we expect to have one solution, but that's not always the case. Let's try to solve this equation and see what happens. Following the guidelines to solve a multi-step equation, the first step would be to clear the parentheses on the right side of the equation by distributing 3. So the left side remains 12x minus 18. Now on the right side, 3 times 4x is 12x. We have 12x minus 3 times 6 is equal to 18. Now looking at the equation closely, notice how the expression on the left is exactly the same as the expression on the right, which means any value of x is going to satisfy the equation or make the equation true, and therefore there's an infinite number of solutions to this equation. But if we didn't notice this, the next step would be to add or subtract to isolate the variable term. Remember, our goal here is to isolate the variable, and right now we have variable terms on both sides of the equation. So if we wanted to undo the positive 12x on the right side of the equation, we would subtract 12x on both sides. So let's go ahead and do that. And now we simplify. On the left side, 12x minus 12x is 0. The left side simplifies to negative 18. On the right side, again we have 12x minus 12x, which is 0. The right side also simplifies to negative 18. So notice in the process of isolating the variable terms simplify out, and we're left with the equation negative 18 equals negative 18. Because this equation is true, this indicates the original equation has an infinite number of solutions. And for short, sometimes you'll just see infinite solutions. Let's look at a second example. Here we have the same type of equation. So for the first step, we clear the parentheses by distributing negative 3 on the left side. So negative 3 times positive 7 is negative 21. So we have negative 21, and then minus negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. Minus negative 6x is the same as plus positive 6x. So the left side simplifies to negative 21 plus 6x. On the right side, we have just 6x. The next step, we add or subtract to isolate the variable term. Notice how we have variable terms on both sides of the equation. To undo the positive 6x on the right side, we would subtract 6x on both sides. Let's go ahead and do this, and now we simplify. 6x minus 6x is 0. The left side simplifies to negative 21. So we have negative 21 equals 6x minus 6x is 0. So once again, notice how when trying to isolate the variable terms simplified out, and we're left with an equation, but this time the equation is false. Negative 21 does not equal 0, so because the resulting equation is false, this indicates the original equation has no solutions. Sometimes we also say the solution does not exist, or for short, DNE. DNE stands for does not exist. So we've discovered that when solving a linear equation in one variable, while we normally expect to have one solution, it is possible to have no solutions, as well as an infinite number of solutions. I hope you found this helpful.